G'day and welcome to this episode of Cole Can Do. In today's episode, we're going to have a look at how to color QR codes during a data merge. So let's have a look at this data merge. So as we go through, we can see that the QR code here changes whenever I change record. But I don't really want the QR code to be black, I want it to be this background blue. So if I click on the QR code, I can go edit QR code and I can change a color, or at least I think I can. So I'll click on there and go, okay, yeah, it looks like it's changed. What's the fuss? Okay, let's either turn the preview off, turn it back on again, boom, it's black again. Maybe that was just a preview bug. Let's just try again, edit QR code, change color. And this time I'm just going to cycle a record. Now you can see, okay, it's gone back to black. So if you want a colored QR code, you can't do it using the QR code fields like you see here. Instead, we need to run a script so that we can generate some colored QR codes. So I'm going to close out of this file, I'm not going to save it. So to make colored QR codes, I've written a script especially for this purpose. So when I run the script, the first thing it asks me is to check to see the swatches panel to make sure the desired color is available. If yes, click next. If no, click new swatch. Well, in this case, it isn't here. I could go new swatch, but what that will do is that will open up the new color swatch palette. But I can't remember what the color was. I'm just going to escape out of that. So instead, I'm going to go load swatches. Okay. So now our color's here, which it's this color. I'm then going to go next. I'm then asked what color I want to make the QR code. So I pick the color that I've just imported. Click OK. And now I need the original data source of the variable data. So it's this one. Click OK. Now presented with a dialog box. So the first thing I have to do is give it a location to save the files. I'm going to put them in my links folder. I then have a choice of which export option I want to use. And by default, it selects PNG and it has the RGB format. It can also be gray, but it can't be CMYK, PNGs don't store CMYK information. I can make a JPEG, that could of course be grey as well, or CMYK. I have a choice with EPS, so I can choose RGB, grey, or CMYK. But notice I can't choose spot colours here. If you want to have a spot colour, it has to be PDF only, I'm afraid at this stage. But with PDF, let's select a preset. I'm going to select my high quality preset. The size, so this is going to be 25. I'm going to use millimeters because I'm in Australia. So now I select a field from the database and I've got a lot of QR codes I can choose from, but the one I'm going to demonstrate is this one, Mac Message. This is used for email. I'm going to go add and go okay. To save you wasting a couple of minutes, I've sped this footage up by 15 times. So that's completed. Now, it will also give you the location. It's taken the name of the original database and then added QR codes to the end of it. So that's important. So let's go back to this file here. So I'm going to turn our data merge back on. But what I want to do is I want to link it to a new data source. Okay. So I've just made the QR codes and within that it's put the new database. So this is an amended database, so it hasn't done anything to the old database. It's made a new one that contains a new field at the end. This one here, QR code. If I turn my preview back on, everything else remains unchanged. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this QR code field here, I'm going to get rid of it. So now if I bring in my QR code again, you'll see it's bringing it to media. But more importantly, under my content placement options, Fitting is fit images proportionally, and that's what I want. If I was to bring in the QR code at 1:1 size, you would see it's brought them in at 25 by 25 millimeters, which is what I wanted the script to do. So as I go from record to record, you'll see the QR code does change. And all these QR codes do work. So just to show that they work, I'll zoom in and we'll go to a few records just to demonstrate. So in this case, let's go to 104. And you can pause the video and hold your mobile phone up to that using any QR code reader you have and scan that. But you'll notice that the QR code is colored the same as a background. The difference is a QR code isn't coming in as a QR code field, it's coming in as an image. It's worth noting too that this technique can be used when using versions of Creative Cloud that aren't 2014 or 2015 that don't let you do variable QR codes. That's it for another video. If you got something out of this video, show me by hitting the like button and subscribe for more great videos. Check out ColeCanDo or InDesign Secrets for the latest articles, or tweet me at ColeCanDo. Until next time, I'll see you later.